Alright, I got a lot of questions in response to the last video that I did, so I'll do another Q&A now. This will be Q&A video number 10. The first series of questions comes from Hisham. The first two being, do you need to bench press to build the chest? Do you need to overhead press to build the shoulders? Can you build those muscles without those exercises? So the answer is no, you don't need to do those exercises. Yes, you can build those muscles without using those exercises. Remember what an exercise is. It's a tool that we use to load a muscle or a specific group of muscles. Your capacity to recruit those muscles when using that tool will determine whether or not you should even be investing in that exercise in the first place. So what might work for somebody else might not work for you. What works for you might not work for somebody else. It comes down to your capacity to recruit when using the tool. If you don't have the capacity to recruit the muscles in the way that is necessary to build them from using that tool, I've put out a whole series of videos that you can use to increase your capacity to recruit. And if that doesn't work, then don't fucking invest in exercises that are not providing the return that you want. The next question was, how do you make a muscle smaller? The way you make a muscle smaller is opposite of what you would do to make a muscle bigger. You want to make a muscle bigger, you train it. You want to make a muscle smaller, you stop training it. It's really that simple. The next question was, how can you measure progressive overload besides just looking at the amount of weight that you're using? Well, you can use anything. The volume that you're doing. Can you do more work with a certain amount of weight? The time frame in which it takes you to complete the work that you're doing. If you can get more work done in less time, that's one way to progressively overload your body. Some more subjective measurements would be, how hard are the muscles contracting? Are you able to contract them harder than you were before? If so, you can progressively overload them that way. Another way would be doing everything slower, because if you could do the same amount of work but slower, taking longer to do it, not longer rest, but keeping the muscles under tension for longer, you're overloading them to some degree in a way that you weren't before. So there's a lot of different ways that you can measure progressive overload. Pretty much anything that can be measured can be used to measure progressive overload. Now the next question comes from David Morales. He says, is strength the key to optimal growth? Now, it's one of the keys, but fortunately, multiple keys can unlock the door to optimal growth, because strength is your ceiling, but you can build muscle through mechanical tension, muscle damage, and metabolic stress. So it doesn't matter how much weight you're lifting to promote the growth response that you want to get. If you wanted to build muscle through metabolic stress or even mechanical tension to some degree, you could also damage the muscles with weights that are not exceeding maxes per se. So there's a lot of different ways that you can promote growth. Now, strength is the ceiling. The stronger you are, the more weight you can use when trying to promote growth through metabolic stress. But it's not necessary to always try to keep getting stronger. In fact, it's not going to be possible. You're going to get to a point where making improvements in how much weight you can lift is going to be very, very tedious and very, very time consuming. And if you're there to build muscle, it's not going to be completely necessary. You might not get a greater return on investment of time and effort by constantly trying to get stronger. With that being said, the formula is very simple. Load times time under optimal tension. The more weight you're lifting, the more times you're lifting it, the greater potential growth response, as long as you don't overwork your capacity to recover. Now, James Hook said something that stood out to me in the comments in the last video that I posted. He said he had a better understanding of why things were the way they were when I talked about how the body is designed to survive. So I want to touch on this real quick. If you understand this one thing, it will explain everything for you. It'll explain motor patterns, why your body builds muscle, why your capacity to showcase your strength is going to improve, and why the body utilizes energy the way it does. The body is designed to survive. When you understand this, it can really shape the way you do what you do to promote the response that you're there to get. Why does your body build muscle? It's not because you want to get jacked. It's because it's protecting itself from the demand that you imposed. Why are you stronger when you train for strength? What is happening there? Your body's becoming more efficient at doing what you're doing, so your capacity to showcase your strength improves. Thus, you look like you're stronger. Why did that happen though? The body's taking the path of least resistance and getting better at doing what you want it to do, and as a result, you're stronger. When you understand why things are happening the way they are, you can really shape the way you do what you do to promote the response that you're there to get. And at the end of the day, what it's all about is imposing a fucking demand. Now, this is the perfect segue to the next series of videos I'm gonna do, because what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna teach you motherfuckers how to impose a fucking demand so that you get the greatest return on your investment of time and effort. You like the information, share it, click the fucking button at the bottom of the screen you're looking at, subscribe to the channel, support me, and I will continue to bring you the best information you're gonna find as it relates to training to build muscle, to get stronger, to lose fat, to look better, to perform better, all that fucking shit.